Hey guys, Ramesh here, back with a new video, and in this video let us discuss about the 10 D2 and the rear view mirrors. Yes, so before going to the video, we have a blog called the menu in which you get latest technology updates. So coming to the video, the 2018 is very aggressive, but not for all the brands like 10 D2 and the Realme smartphones. Oh stop, 10 D and the Realme started the aggressive pricing, right? But not in 2018. I will agree with you. They offer the aggressive price, but not in 2018. So recently, Realme brands launched the Realme 2 smartphone. So now let us compare the Realme 1 with the Realme 2 smartphone and with the pricing. So coming to the Realme 1, it has Helio P60 processor and with no fingerprint sensor, was launched at 8,990. And recently, Realme launched the Realme 2 smartphone. Coming to the Realme, it has Snapdragon 450 with the fingerprint sensor with the dual camera setup, and it was launched at 9,000 rupees. You guys agree that it has fingerprint sensor and the dual camera setup, but according to the processor, Realme 1 is great. I personally choose Realme 1 because it has a great processor and the face unlock is damn fast. Sometimes I thought I don't need fingerprint sensor. Yes, the face unlock of Realme 1 is damn fast. Apart from camera, the cameras on the Realme 2 were good, but the camera on the Realme 1 is also good. But I want the performance, not the camera. So, you definitely have to agree that Realme 2 is the downgrade of Realme 1. And it was launched a little bit high. Now, let us talk about the 10D brand. You already know that 10D1 launched at 4,998 rupees with the Snapdragon 425 processor and also with the fingerprint sensor. Yes, whereas Redmi 5A cannot offer fingerprint sensor, right? And 10D launched recently 10D2 smartphone without fingerprint sensor and it was priced at 6,999. Now let's compare the 10D1 with the 10D2. Now coming to the 10D1, it has Snapdragon 425 processor and with the fingerprint sensor, it was launched at 4,999. And now coming to the 10D2 smartphone, it has Snapdragon 425 processor and it was priced around 6,999 without fingerprint sensor. Yes, there is a huge difference and the price is very high according to the 10D1 smartphone with the same processor and without the fingerprint sensor. Our expectations was inverted, right? We expected the 10D2 would be a great as a 10D1 smartphone, but they completely made wrong with the 10D2 smartphone. They launched the smartphone with the 7,000 rupees. So every brand in 2018 was trying to offer aggressive pricing. So recently, Vivo launched the Vivo V11 Pro smartphone with the price tag of 26,000 with the under display fingerprint sensor and the Halo Vivo display. Now considering the Vivo track record from the recent, if they brought the smartphone with the same specifications, they would have priced around 35,000. But recently Vivo launched the smartphone with 25,990. Yes, it was very aggressive according to the Vivo. Every smartphone in 2018 was trying to offer the aggressive pricing, apart from the Realme and the 10D2 smartphones. Of course, I agree they brought aggressive pricing with theirs. Smartphones, but they were not offering aggressive pricing in 2018. So hope in future they will come with the aggressive pricing. So thank you for watching.